my idea for a college football playoff, for the ideal college football playoff, is for an 8-team system. Yep. Right. So we no longer have to worry about some conferences being excluded this year.
Yep.
No Pac-12, no Big Ten.
Yep.
Okay.
And we'll get to that later.
We'll get to that.
Egregious. Later. Oh, drove me nuts.
And beyond that, there's no room for the smaller upstart teams. And really, that's what makes March Madness so fun, is to see some of the small teams be able to compete.
Yeah.
And I think we can bring that element with an 8-team playoff. You could even talk me into a 16 playoff, but I want to present to you tonight an 8-team playoff. Okay. And so here's my argument. Number one, every single conference gets an automatic berth. Now, it's up to each conference how they want to determine that. Some conferences, like the Big 12, used to only go by regular season. If they want to do that, great.
Yeah.
The point is, every single conference is represented by one team, guaranteed.
Okay.
Simple so far.
I love it. Yep.
Simple so far.
So you have five teams.
Power five conferences, so you have five teams automatically.
Yep.
And then we have a sixth team that's an automatic bid from a non-Power 5 team, meaning it could be a team like Notre Dame, so an independent school like Notre Dame or Navy.
Yep.
It could be a non-Power 5 conference. So this year it might be University of Central Florida. Some years it could be Boise State. And then, so now we have six teams, and that leaves two at-large bids for Power 5 teams or other deserving teams. Okay, so this year, here is how it would play out in my mind. Number one is Clemson. Okay, Clemson is the ACC winner, and the selection committee has them as the number one team. I've got no reason to doubt that. I'm putting them at number one. Number two, I'm putting Oklahoma. Again, we're just going to follow the simple formula so far. So far, we have our ACC and our Big 12 teams. Third team we have is Georgia. Okay, Georgia was the SEC champ. Great. Good for Georgia. Go Bulldogs. Here we go. Now here's where we start to get a little interesting. I'm going to leave with what the selection committee had and put Bama at 4. And this is my first at-large team. Okay? Alabama at 4, first at-large team. And then at number 5 I'm putting Ohio State, which was the Big Ten champion. Ah, if only we could play some sort of game with a football where on a gridiron where we could determine who is better between Alabama and Ohio State. Well, I have good news. In my playoff, this happens in the first round. And then at number 6, I have the Pac-12 champion, USC. Okay. We talk about Ohio State being left out. USC had 2 losses as well.
They played a season without a bye. There was no bye week, which is brutal.
One of their losses was on a short week on the road in a tough environment.
Yep.
I think SC has every right to be as upset as Ohio State.
Really?
Number 7, I have Central Florida. This is our non-Power 5 auto bid.
And in your system, is there only one non-Power 5 team?
One guaranteed.
Oh, wow. Okay,
one guaranteed. And then we have 2 at-large bids, which could be any team. So if Notre Dame and UCF were both deserving, great. They both
love it.
And then my second at-large team is Wisconsin. One loss. I think they made it through the regular season unscathed, lost a fairly close game to Ohio State. So here is my top 8. And how this plays out is, first round is at the higher seed's home. Okay, so Clemson would be hosting Wisconsin. Oklahoma would be hosting Central Florida. Tell me you wouldn't love that matchup. Georgia,
fantastic.
Georgia and SC. Oh my gosh. And then, of course, Alabama, Ohio State. Semifinals are played in Atlanta and Phoenix. Finals is played in my former hometown of Pasadena, California. What do you think?